Hello. Few people believe that talent can be copied and pasted from one individual to another. I'd like to tell you a story about an amazing young man that did just that. This great talent, a true virtuoso, blossomed and flowered and died in the skies over the desert of North Africa in 1942, during the turmoil of war in the air. His name was Hans-Joachim Marseille. And he did what everyone believed was impossible. Hans-Joachim Marseille was a charismatic young Berliner of French Huguenot descent who joined the German Luftwaffe early in World War II. He would eventually become, arguably, the greatest fighter pilot of all time. But the start to Marseille's combat career was less than auspicious. Although he managed to down 7 aircraft, he would dive impulsively into large enemy formations and was himself shot down 4 times during the Battle of Britain. At times, he barely managed to nurse his riddled and wrecked aircraft back to the coast of France. Marseille's commander had little patience with a reckless and exuberant jazz-loving playboy, who would party all night and fly and fight with little or no sleep the next day. As punishment, Marseille was passed over for promotion and posted off to North Africa in complete disgrace. The humiliated Marseille's entrance into North Africa was even less impressive. On his first sortie, he was yet again shot down. But Marseille's unorthodox nature and strong personal presence had caught the eye of his new commander. He saw potential and decided to mentor Marseille in air combat. Together they devised a strict 6-step personal development plan for Marseille. Firstly, to improve his vision by exposing his eyes to the desert sun and shunning alcohol for large amounts of milk. Secondly, special physical exercises that would enable him to sustain long periods of high G forces. Thirdly, practicing his aerobatics, giving him outstanding control over his aircraft. Fourthly, by practicing firing and high deflection shooting while in sharp turns, inverted, or even in skids. And fifthly, a detailed study of enemy tactics and aircraft. Sixthly, improved tactics is where Marseille became a great innovator of air warfare. He preferred to attack large formations all on his own, using just a single wingman to provide warnings from a safe distance. This enabled him to quickly fire at anything he saw without fear of hitting a friendly. His unorthodox tactics effectively caused confusion and panic, and the extreme and erratic maneuvering caused him to become invisible to the enemy. Marseille believed that this was far more important than the speed of flying. He exhaustively practiced these skills over and over, and his victories rapidly mounted. Soon, he became the best shooter in aerial combat, needing only 15 rounds per victory. And as a master of deflection shooting, he easily scored from extreme angle on approaches, which is impossible for most pilots. Marseille explained, "I fully integrated all the motions of air combat with difficult maneuvers. I can keep control of the aircraft in any situation, even in the tightest turns and at the lowest possible speeds. I make all the motions unconsciously. It allows me to fly my plane as though I had wings." Statistically, Marseille became the best combat pilot ever when considering rounds fired and strings of multiple victories, and doing so on a consistent basis. Then, on the 1st of September 1942, all of Marseille's efforts came together in spectacular fashion. On the first patrol, they were intercepted by British fighters. Marseille flamed one as the top cover of Spitfires descended past them. He quickly chopped the throttle and dropped his flap, forcing the Spitfire to overshoot, and Marseille shot it down. In short order, he victimized another two, four planes in just 11 minutes. On the second escort mission of that day, they ran into a gaggle of British fighters that formed a defensive Loughbury circle. Marseille entered the circle from above and shot down two on the way down. As the circle broke, he blazed three more, and then he and his wingman climbed back up again. A sixth plane was taken with a long deflection shot. They attacked another group, and a seventh was shot down. An eighth was trailing white coolant smoke and was dispatched quickly from behind. Eight planes in 10 minutes. After lunch, they escorted some bombers to Alam El Hafa. A melee of swirling dogfights ensued as 15 British fighters attacked them. The fracas went down to ground level, and the redoubtable Marseille accounted for five more destroyed in 7 minutes. The rest fled. A total of 17 victories in one day. Few pilots in the entire history of air combat would ever equal this number of victories during their entire careers. But then, just 30 days later, Marseille was flying a new aircraft when a glycol line broke and caught fire. His cockpit quickly filled with smoke, and he had to bail out, but he was still over enemy lines, and Marseille had no desire to become a prisoner of war, so he held on. Unable to see or breathe, his wingman guided and cajoled him onwards, but it became obvious that the aircraft was doomed. As he crossed the lines, Marseille flicked the aircraft onto its back and tried to drop clear, not realizing that the aircraft was in a steep dive. The increased airflow pinned him against the canopy, but eventually he managed to struggle free, but was knocked unconscious by the fin that carried his 158 victory markings. He never recovered to deploy his parachute and fell to his death 4 miles south of Sidi Abdul Rahman. He was buried where he fell. At Marseille's funeral, Adolf Galland, Germany's general of fighters, was moved to call him the unrivaled virtuoso amongst fighter pilots of the Second World War. Marseille was only 22.
Ay, 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 ay.